Hello there and welcome to another edition of Ion Port, proudly brought to you by West Blue Consulting Limited, Ghana Oil Company Limited and Ghana Community Network Services. The media partner is the Business and Financial Times. And people, again, we are reminding you that the Lagos Hope, the world's largest floating vessel with that library, is still here at the terminal port and will be leaving on the 2nd of October. A lot of people continue to come in. The queue here is amazing. We're just waiting till it's about 2 because on Sundays they open at 2. And about 2 o'clock, you can't imagine the line that you'll be seeing here. A lot of children, lots of adults, all struggling to get into the Lagos Hope. You need to be here. Watch some of the drama, also grab some of those favorite books of yours and go and read them because definitely it will be of benefit to you and your family. This week, people, last week we started talking about the port expansion with Mr. Mohamed Samara and trying to understand how far are things happening. Now we know that from the first week of October, we are going to see physical work on the port expansion of Tema Harbour. And this week, we're talking about another aspect of the port expansion, that is the Tema Motorway expansion. A lot of people are trying to find out exactly what it is we are supposed to see. Are we going to see the motorway being expanded along with the Tema port expansion? All of that next. And another area that people had heard linked to your port expansion as a motorway, some bit of extra road expansion of a sort, and particular mention have been made of the motorway. Are we likely to see something work along the port expansion or maybe even before?
Before it's okay, not possible, but certainly in the future there will be some project. The stakeholders of the road development project are not the same ones of the port. On the motorway and on the internal roads or the access between here, the port and the motorway, we have to create kind of a new concession. And the stakeholders there are made up of the Ministry of Roads and Highways, Ghana Highway Authority, the Department of Urban Roads, as well as the municipalities that we cross. So the stakeholders are slightly more different than the stakeholders of
the port expansion.
We progressed a little bit faster with the port than the road. With the road, it's the two foreign investors, that is Bolloré and APMT, will sponsor the development of the road with the Ministry of Roads and Highways, as well as the Highway Authority and Urban Roads.
And that has not been concluded?
No, it's on track. It will require parliamentarian approvals. It has to go through design and this. It is happening. The engagement is there. It's progressing, but things have to take its own course over there. It requires first cooperation from the public. The right of way has been already encroached upon by various people. There is some movable assets or some people parked there. Earth moving equipment, cranes, whatever for hire, they have to move aside, you know, for the job to be done. Okay. There is some few containers or some few businesses establish themselves on the right of way, you know. So basically, they have to move out of the right of way.
But those are not serious impediments.
They're not. They should not. Actually, it's for their benefit. It's for the community. Okay. This isn't a project, you know, that will benefit anybody other than the community itself. So we really need to be cooperative with each other, you know. There is no payback, no gain to Meridian Port Services out of
that. It's just for the good of the people.
The good of the people and the good of everybody.
Okay. And that one, how soon are we likely to see that one being done?
The sooner we can clear the right of way, the sooner we can have kind of the design approved with the finalized, the kind of the engagement, the protocol engagement, or call it the agreement with the Ministry of Roads and Highway finalized. We can start immediately.
Immediately.
As immediate as next week. If we can finalize this week, next week we can.
So we can only plead with the Ministry of Roads and Highways that kindly speed up whatever negotiations you have, because we all need to see an expanded motorway as well as a very free motorway roundabout, particularly for those of us who commute a lot between those twin cities of Tema and Accra.
Hello.
Good morning. This is Samantha Wendy. I am sending a purchase order from SAT Ventures International. Our policy for new supplies is 2 containers to start with, but you must deliver within 30 days.
Don't worry at all. I'm going to get you the 4 containers within 30 days or less.
Bye. To get his pineapple slices from his country to his clients overseas, Mr. Appiah and his representatives have to complete a number of regulatory compliance procedures to various international trade stakeholders.
Hey, Mama, what's going on? Catch it right? I mean, how? Hey.
Using single window, Mr. Appiah has completed all his international trade procedures through one portal. He has registered his company information, applied for the necessary permit, certificates and licenses, and all that remains is for him to get a text alert for clearance and movement of goods. And that's how simple facilitating international trade could be in a single window environment. You can offer competitive services to your trading partners in China, America, even here, in a simpler, faster, and cost-effective way. Single window, the only way to Ghana's economic growth, is in our hands.
When cleaning your vehicle by valeting, steaming, waxing, or polishing, make sure the engine is also sound. Servicing your vehicle with gold synthetic oil and any quality gold oil massages the engine, removes deposit, protects it from wear and tear for longer lasting performance, and makes your vehicle fuel pumped. Made for diesel and super engines. Remember, after every 15,000 kilometers of enjoying your ride, service your engine with Gold Synthetic Oil.
We are a champion. That's why I, Azuma Nelson, 3 times world boxing champion and a patriot, always choose Goel.
Ashine Pankasa. Goel, good energy.
For all ship repairs and maintenance work, count on the Takoradi Shipyard. Takoradi Shipyard, efficiency, reliability, and perfection.
Coming up next are some of the activities that have taken place in and around the ports and maritime industry for the past week.
A delegation from the Ghana Police Service, led by the Inspector General of Police, Dr. John Kudalo, has called on the management of the Ghana Ports and Harbors Authority to deepen the cordial relationship between the two institutions. The working visit forms part of measures put in place by the police administration to engage stakeholders in order to deliberate on a peaceful general elections in December 2016. The IGP commended GPHA for the continuous support given to the Tema Regional Police Command, especially with regards to the timely manner the police administration gets their equipment cleared from the port. He also commended the port for supporting the police administration with a Nissan Navara pickup.
For us, you are very serious and worthy partners in our quest to ensure security and peace for our motherland. One, when we come here, even our goods are choked here or stranded, and we have no means even to clear them, going through the bureaucracy. On more than one occasion, you've come to our help, our assistance by let it go through as early and smoothly as possible, meeting our police hallmark and demands. Because in our parlance, we say policing, everything is done intentionally, intentionally, Terminus is very important.
In response, the Director General of the Ghana Ports and Harbors Authority, Richard Anamu, recounted the support the port receives from the police administration, especially the marine police, in making sure the marine environment is safe. He stated that construction works for the Tema port expansion will commence in October and therefore called for security enforcement to ensure success of the project.
Because of the increase in traffic and in the coming year, especially in Tema, in the next 4 years, there's going to be massive expansion of the port. Beginning next month, the construction is going to start. And here we'll be pumping over 1 billion into the sea. The entire road from here right down to Shahid is going to be heavily occupied. The entire area of Tema Port is going to be very, very busy. So in the next few years, we are really going to be relying on you to come to our aid as far as these things are concerned.
Richard Anamu also revealed that construction works for slip roads on the Tema end of the motorway roundabout would commence in the coming weeks, hence the need for more personnel from the police administration to be deployed to control the heavy traffic situation that would be generated.
We'll be starting work on the motorway, especially the Tema roundabout on the motorway. I think all is almost set for that to start. So I took the opportunity to make an appeal, you know, so that you can deploy a lot of people in that place.
A forum on ratification of World Trade Organization's trade facilitation agreement focusing on making cross-border trade easier for Ghanaian businesses has been held in Accra. The WTO's trade facilitation agreement provides a unique opportunity to promote inclusive growth by making cross-border trade easier, quicker, and less costly for businesses of all sizes. The agreement includes provisions for lowering import tariffs and agriculture subsidies, making it easier for developing countries to trade with the developed world in global markets. Commissioner General of the Ghana Revenue Authority, George Blankson, said a trade facilitation agreement is a WTO's first ever multilateral accord that aims to simplify customs regulations for the cross-border movement of goods. He stated that facilitating trade and modernizing customs procedures essential for increasing prosperity for all in Ghana and the ECOWAS sub-region.
With the adoption of appropriate border management and trade reforms, trade volume increases, driving up with it revenue from duties and taxes on trade. The agreement also provides for a reduction in red tape at the international borders by reforming customs bureaucracies and formalities. Bottlenecks along trade routes are some of the most stubborn obstacles for economic growth and development in West Africa.
The Vice President of the Global Alliance for Trade Facilitation said Ghana's economy stands to benefit immensely from the trade facilitation.
I think especially when you look at the ECOWAS region, the sad reality is that the cost of trading here is 3 times higher to trade within the region than is actually to trade externally due to charges and waiting times. So not only will countries like Ghana actually get a bigger share of the trade expansion, it will also diversify their economies in terms of both products exported and markets reached.
An executive-level training workshop on trade facilitation has been organized for chief executive officers as part of the Ghana National Single Window Implementation Project. The objective of the workshop was to train participants on the usage of the Trade Facilitation Guide, reform efforts to stimulate the sharing of best practices, and the discussions of opportunities for interagency cooperation. The Trade Facilitation Guide contains process simplification, cross-border management, consultation and cooperation for trade facilitation, single window implementation, and document simplification.
Everybody's talking about trade facilitation now, but some countries have said this is a game changer, and we're going to use this to really up the level of the country's competitiveness and engagement and trade performance.
The Commissioner General of the Ghana Revenue Authority called on stakeholders to show commitment to the strategic plan of the National Single Window Project so that the country can derive the needed benefit.
We must all show commitment to the strategic plan that has been outlined. But we must also be mindful of the fact that the strategic plan or the roadmap is not cast in stone. As we move on, as we implement, let's all have a certain sense of flexibility to be able to tweak things to meet the agencies, the exigencies of the situation as we move along.
The Director General of the Ghana Ports and Harbors Authority, Richard Anamu, said the port's expansion would allow bigger vessels to bring in more cargoes, hence the need for an efficient clearing processes.
We are carrying out expansion in the ports, both Tema and Takoradi. And what we are saying is that even in our current state, this is the situation. And we are going to expand the ports that will be going from 11.5 meters to 16 meters draft, large, bigger vessels. You know, where one vessel will be carrying several thousands of containers. And already the port is getting choked with several vessels coming in with tons and tons of rice and cement and all that. And if we do not see the clearance of goods to our ports as being very efficient, then, of course, that is going to backlash.
The Chief Executive Officer of West Blue Consulting, Valentina Minta, said traders can now access their customs classification and valuation report within 48 hours through the Ghana National Single Window Project.
That all agencies have to look at each of these processes. What do we commit? What is the time we commit to issuing this in? For example, the CCVR on pass, customs has a 48 hours service level agreement. So in the 49th hour, you see emails coming through, where's my CCVR, where's my CCVR, because that is strictly being adhered to.
Shipping lines can now heave a huge sigh of relief following the introduction of an online vessel booking system by the Ghana Ports and Harbors Authority. The online vessel system forms part of the efforts by the Port Authority to automate all its processes to improve the way it receives vessels into the port. As a result, shipping lines and freight forwarders have been taking through all the procedures in using the system in order to abreast themselves of its usage. The system will allow shipping lines apply for vessel space faster and quicker in the comfort of their homes.
We are trying to make it very easy for shipping lines to do business in GPHA. We don't want the situation where people will be applying things on sheets of paper and running around chasing stuff for approvals to happen. We want everything to be smooth, to be real-time, to be accessible everywhere, and that's the main aim of the electronic booking system.
Hitherto, a vessel booking meeting is conveyed where shipping lines assemble for the allocation of berthing space for their vessel. The online vessel booking system is expected to enhance efficiency in the port and improve service delivery to customers.
The online booking system is connected to the single window operated by West Blue and also to our terminal operating system. So it is an interconnected kind of window through which the stakeholders will have to transact business in a very efficient and expedited manner.
The corporate marketing and public affairs manager of GPHA, Paul Asariansa, said the entire port area has been connected with Wi-Fi to ensure the smooth implementation of the online vessel booking system.
All agents, all freight forwarders who transact business with us will have to be IT compliant. And as I indicated, we have wired the entire port environment with Wi-Fi facilities. And you have 24-hour access to Wi-Fi. So there's nothing like you don't have credit to connect. You have access to the Wi-Fi.
The Ghana Revenue Authority Customs Division with its technical partner West Blue Consulting have been commended at the 5th edition of the International Single Window Conference in Morocco for the successes chalked since the inception of the Pre-Arrival Assessment Reporting System, PAS, which is the first phase of the overall National Single Window Project. The objective of the conference was to recognize virtual single window for foreign trade and the requirement for an inclusive cooperation which the two Ghanaian organizations, Ghana Revenue Authority, Customs Division with its technical partner, West Blue Consulting, were recognized to be pursuing in Ghana. The Ghana Revenue Authority Customs Division team was led by the Deputy Commissioner Operations, Fred Gavo. The conference was opened by the head of government of Morocco, Abdellah Benkira, where he emphasized the benefits of single window in countries and what Africa stands to gain by developing its own single window. the Minister of Equipment, Transport and Logistics, alongside his team and other dignitaries, called on Ghana's single window exhibition stand to understand implementation processes of the Ghana National Single Window operations so far. Trade associations in Ghana are accusing some shipping lines operating in the country of allegedly charging terminal handling charges in spite of a directive by the Minister of Transport, Fifi Kwete, for them to stop. Executive Secretary of the Importers and Exporters Association, Samson Asaki, described the act of the shipping lines as an insult to the intelligence of players in the maritime industry. He accused the shipping lines of hiding under the term Incoterm, meaning international commercial terms, to charge the terminal handling charges in overseas and asking importers to pay in Ghana.
What the shipping line are now doing is that they are standing on the minister's letter and that portion of the statement that they have the liberty per the Incoterms. They are producing an invoice for terminal handling charge in Europe or in overseas and asking the Ghanaian importer here that you either ask your exporter there where they brought the cargo from to pay them before they release their documents to them.
He said the act of the shipping lines is unhealthy for the growth of business in Ghana. Samson Asaki called on importers to resist the payment of the terminal handling charges by not dealing with shipping lines who charge the THC.
We will also use the opportunity, of course, to advise the shippers not to use any shipping line that will charge you a terminal handling charge or that will invoice you with freight and hide to invoice you another invoice that will carry terminal handling charge. That is what we want to do. And we want to know which company is ready not to charge terminal handling charge so that we will tell the importers and exporters that you can now use this shipping line because they are ready to work with us.
He said all the major trade associations comprising the AGI, GUTA and QBAC, among others, will on Tuesday, 27th September 2016, hold a press conference to register their displeasure at the shipping lines and call on government to take drastic action against the wayward shipping lines.
We, the key business associations, headed by the AGI, Chamber of Commerce, GUTA, Importers and Exporters Association, Food and Beverages, Ghana Institute of Freight Forwarders, Custom Brokers Association, QBAC, and the rest of the associations, Greater Accra Shippers Committee, we have met and decided to hold a joint press conference with the importers and exporters and the agents, put out an information or a communication to government, and for that matter, we think it's going to carry a weight.
The German Development Corporation, GIZ, together with their project partner, Sysmex, has donated a Sysmex XN hematology analyzer worth 100,000 euros to the Ghana Ports and Harbors Authority Hospital as part of their Prevention is Better Than Cure project. The state-of-the-art equipment is expected to enhance the capacity of laboratory testing at GPH's main clinic and therefore improve the implementation of prevention and health promotion services at the facility. The XN hematology analyzer, which can perform 1,000 lab tests within an hour, can be used to check anemia and diagnose all blood-related diseases. The Prevention is Better Than Cure project is implemented in cooperation with Ghana Association of Health Institutions, GAKI, of which the Ghana Ports and Harbors Authority Hospital is a founding member. GPHA Hospital was the only institution selected amongst 26 other GAKI institutions as the beneficiary of this donation because of efforts put in place by its management to improve healthcare delivery.
We are aware of the current projects being undertaken by GAKI with the opening of the new facility and the kind of equipments that we have over there. And we think that this is one of the world's leading hematology analyzers that should be at a place like Abuja.
The head of medical services of GPHA, Dr. Anab BC, commended GIZ for the gesture and added that it will go a long way to enhance healthcare delivery at the GPHA clinic.
GIZ decided that they will give us this donation because they trust in our system. They say that we are well positioned to put this equipment to good use. It means that you are preempting things. You're going to check and see if somebody is going. You don't wait for somebody to go into crisis. They say the HB level, the hemoglobin level is too low. You need to transfuse the person. If you monitor well, that means that you can intervene and you can save lives with us.
The regional manager for SysMex, Eric Osei, who donated the items, revealed that additional trainings will be provided for staff in the laboratory.
Hello.
Good morning. This is Samantha Wendy. I am sending a purchase order from SAT Ventures International. Our policy for new supplies is 2 containers to start with, but you must deliver within 30 days.
Don't worry at all. I'm going to get you the 4 containers within 30 days or less.
Bye. To get his pineapple slices from his country to his clients overseas, Mr. Appiah and his representatives have to complete a number of regulatory compliance procedures to various international trade stakeholders.
Hey, Baba, what's going on? Get it right? I mean, how? How? Hey.
Using single window, Mr. Appiah has completed all his international trade procedures through one portal. He has registered his company information, applied for the necessary permit, certificates and licenses, and all that remains is for him to get a text alert for clearance and movement of goods. And that's how simple facilitating international trade could be in a single window environment. You can offer competitive services to your trading partners in China, America, even here, in a simpler, faster, and cost-effective way. Single window, the only way to Ghana's economic growth, is in our hands.
When cleaning your vehicle by valeting, steaming, waxing, or polishing, make sure the engine is also sound. Servicing your vehicle with gold synthetic oil and any quality gold oil massages the engine, removes deposit, protects it from wear and tear for longer lasting performance, and makes your vehicle fuel pumped. Made for diesel and super engines. Remember, after every 15,000 kilometers of enjoying your ride, service your engine with Gold Synthetic Oil.
We are a champion. That's why I, Azuma Nelson, 3 times world boxing champion and a patriot, always choose Goel.
Ashine Pankasa. Goel, good energy.
For all ship repairs and maintenance work, count on the Takoradi Shipyard. Takoradi Shipyard, efficiency, reliability, and perfection.
Our schedules of vessels in the port, those at anchorage, plus those expected for the coming week, and the Bank of Ghana exchange rate next. Well, so that's it for this week's episode of Eye on Port. And I have to remind you once again that the Lagos Hope vessel, the world's largest floating vessel, will be leaving the Tema port on the 2nd of October. If you haven't been here already, then you are really missing out. A lot of people, dignitaries included, very important personalities, diplomats and all, have been coming into the port to see the world's largest floating vessel with a library on board and enjoying themselves to all those drama series and all the rest. Lots of kids are having fun. If you haven't brought those kids here, you are indeed missing out. Thank you for watching the program and thanks to the entire crew. Next week we'll be coming on board the Lagos Hope. So for those of you who will only get the opportunity to see us on screen, we will be on board the Lagos Hope next week. Thanks to the crew, Robert Nantechi, Godwin Kabute, Solomon Anderson, Joe Lavo, Nelson Fiajo, and the executive producers, Paul Asari Ansa, as well as Abna Sewa Opokufosu.